Hi, this is a continuation of the Total Air Temperature Simulator project. I have received this week two parcels. The first one is the PCB, the second one is the front panel. Okay, so this is the PCB of the main board. There is here the main PCB, and I have attached also the PCB for the keypad. We see later the schematics of the main board. Okay, so this is the front panel from Schaeffer AG. Air ditch by nature. There will be on the right here a connector for the total air temperature probe. It will be this connector here. Here, on the right, there will be the pressure port. It's perfect. There will be here, on the bottom right, a sub-D15 for the digitizer input. It will be a connector like that. Okay, perfect. Here, on the bottom, there will be the servo control for the total air temperature probe. There will be here a USB connector, here a power supply input, a DC input, actually between 9 and 29 volts, an on-off switch and an LED indicator. And there will be here in the middle an OLED display. This one here, two lines of 16 characters. And here four push buttons. And two LEDs, one which indicates that the servo is stabilized, and the second one for the manual temperature mode. It will be possible also to set manually a given output temperature. This will be indicated by this LED, otherwise the temperature will be set according to the altitude, which depends on the static pressure. Okay, so normally the front panel should fit perfectly. L'intrusion, ok, it is the case. On this page, there is the block schematic. Each block here corresponds to one page of the schematic. We can see here on the left the small keypad assembly. There is nothing special, only 5 push buttons and 2 LEDs. We can see here on this first page the power supply. There is nothing special. The main power supply is a voltage of 7.2 volts here. This voltage is generated using a DC-DC converter. There is also a measurement of the power supply input voltage here using this resistor divider. The signal is connected to one analog input of the microcontroller. There is also a filtering here for EMC. There is another filter here. At the input, there is a fuse. There is a diode which avoids the reverse polarity, and there is a TVS diode. On that page, there is a digitizer input, lines D2 here to C4, and we have also 4 lines here for the 4 push buttons. These 16 bits are fed to 2 parallel to serial converters. Here we have a DAC which uses actually a pulse width modulation. This signal is an output of the microcontroller. It is fed to that switch. The output of the switch is commuted from the ground here to the positive reference power supply here. At the output, there is a pulse width. And the mean value of this pulse width depends on the duty cycle of that signal here. This signal is fed to a second order low pass filter, which uses these 2 resistors, these 2 capacitors, and also this op-amp here. And this signal is fed to the servo control, which permits to set the total air temperature probe resistance. On this page, there is a dual ADC. It is actually a dual 16-bit signal delta ADC. This dual ADC is used in order to translate the analog output of the sensors into a digital value. This ADC here is connected to the microcontroller using an I2C bus. Both inputs are differential. I made some measurement on the sensors. For the pitot-sensor, actually the voltage at the output is approximately 2.5 volts. So this voltage corresponds to zero differential pressure. This is why the second input here of the ADC is connected to 2.5 volts reference voltage made with this voltage reference here, max 6008. It is the same for the second input for the static pressure. I have measured at the output of the sensor of the static pressure a voltage of 4.2 volts approximately. I assume that for a complete vacuum, the voltage should be close to 2.5 volts. So the range is approximately plus or minus 1.7 volts. So this should be compatible with the internal voltage reference of this ADC, which is 2.048 volts. The last page concerns the microcontroller. You can see the OLED display here, the programming interface, and various inputs outputs. So we can see the SPI bus for the digitizer, these four lines here. There is a servo control error, which comes from the servo control assembly for the total air temperature probe. We have here the transmit and receive lines for the UART interface. There is here the I2C bus for the ADC, the pulse width modulation output, which uses an output compare pin here. There is here an analog input for the measurement of the input voltage. These two lines correspond to the two LEDs, and there is here a signal which permits to activate the servo control. That's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.